Hi, this is Trip, and welcome to my channel. Today, it's Moe's Southwest Grill, the Homewrecker Burrito. Moe's. Download the Order Ahead app. I like the branding there, of course. Those are all the chips in there. I got a bunch of chips, you know. And he started piling them on in the bag. I said, no, just three scoops is enough. And I got some guacamole. And they put it on he put it in a little side, almost like another portion for me. I mean, there's a bunch of it here. Take a look at it. I had trouble understanding him across the barrier, the food line, because he was kind of mumbling and had sort of a soft voice, and I thought, wow, there's me. And he couldn't hear me very well, and I told him, I apologize because I was, for some years in my life, you know, I played in bands, and I had a stack of amplifiers as tall as me on my right side, and that's where the guitar came out. Then later, when I switched to bass. So, I have hearing problems, young people. Please be careful. I don't mean just live music, but I mean when you know, listening to the headphones and all that. Okay, I digress as usual. This is the... here's the Homewrecker. This is the 12-inch. The 12-inch for about $8. And you can get the Homewrecker Jr., which is a 10-inch tortilla, for $7.19. So basically, I already figured this before, you get 20% more food if you're by paying 11% more. In other words, if the 12 inch is $7.99 minus the $7.19 for the Homewrecker Jr., the 10 inch, divided by $7.19 is 11% more, okay? Because the 12-inch costs 11% more than the 10-inch. But then you figure how much more quantity you're getting. You're getting 12-inch minus 10 divided by 10. 20% more. And you should do that every time you go to order something. Like, I know I'm not going to have this entire sandwich. So I asked him to please cut it in half. So I'll have the other half later. And I'll have the other chips later. So here's half of the sandwich. I'll save the other half. I call this lunch, and I call this one supper. I got two kinds of sauce. I got a milder sauce, which is the tomatillo green sauce, and this is called something. This is a hotter, like medium. This is called like Kaiser, like by the Kaiser or something. Here's the Kaiser. I don't know what that means. So, these are little food economics there. It's not going to tingle because it has ice in it and a lemon. I was so thirsty. Okay. First, I want to check out this. Now, here's a close up of it. You can see the cross section there. Okay. See from the side. That side there, all around. And I got the chicken. You can actually choose between steak, chicken, pork, carnitas, and ground beef, or even tofu, I think. So, did I mention steak? So on this I got rice. Rice, black-eyed beans, and like I said, the chicken. I got nice tomatoes on it. It's got shredded cheese, shredded lettuce. There was a sign there that said that they're not serving romaine because of a problem with the romaine in California. So first I want to have the guacamole. Muy delicioso, the guacamole. Guacamole. Oh, and by the way, this is one of the most popular dishes. It is the most popular at Moe's Southwest Grill. Another popular option, alternative, is the bowl, the burrito bowl, and people like that who are on special diets like vegans or vegetarians, because it's easy to customize. I did not want any guacamole sauce in my burrito. I don't like a lot of messy food. Now I'm gonna try these little chips and this Kaiser sauce, Kaiser salsa. As you can hear, it is very crunchy. These little chips are delicious. Now, for the main ingredient. Coup de grâce, la entrée. Alrighty. Could be a bit messy. This fork for eating up the little stuff from the inside. I better look at the ingredients, the inside ingredients. See, we got our tomatoes there, and our chicken. Oh, anyway, I'm talking too much, as usual. Golly, I'm licking my mouth around all this food here. Bunch of stuff there. There's a nice smell to it. Probably end up eating this with my fork. as Andy Griffith would say, this is good. It's fantastic. Little bit of heat coming off there. Kind of zesty. Very zesty. Half and half tea. That is, in the South we say half sweet, half unsweet, half and half. Pot au moi. These things can get a little messy. I wish you were here. We would enjoy one together. This is delicious. Oh, and I asked the boy to put a little burst of lime into it, a little squeeze of the lime, and this was lime or lemon, anything like that is good. I'll be using this napkin quite a bit. Let's alternate back to a little bit of these. These nice chips and these crunch sounds. A very high crunch factor. This is very spicy. This was really a good value for everything that they gave me too. I'm already past 15 minutes, and your time is valuable. So I'm going to finish this meal on my own, plus I still have another half for supper. Remember our economics lesson on fast food. Sometimes you can get twice as much by paying just a little bit more. As you already know, right? So have half now and half later. It doesn't mean you have to overeat. Especially you working young people, single people. You can have half of something at lunch, you know, and have the other half for your supper. How about that? I mean, don't live on fast food. But when you do find yourself really short of time, or at work you're trying to save some time, then it's an option. Okay. This was Moe's Southwest Grill, Homewrecker, the 12-inch tortilla. And it was really delicious, and it is the most popular item at Moe's, from what I've read, or what the people there tell me. And this pretty much concludes the video. I thank you for watching. I hope you will tune in next time. Ciao. You hear that cricket? Every time I hear that cricket, the video cuts off.